Good morning. Riding in the park. Riding through the tunnel inside the park. Because that sounds nice. But mainly because I needed to do something there and I was very limited on time. So that explains my illegal reason to be there. Besides, it's not like anybody is watching this. I did two different vlogs that have both failed. The first one just failed in its principle and decided not to do it anymore. The second one I really wanted to do, but the audio was really, really fucked up. And I could bump the audio, but then at some point the noise around it was too much to filter out. So that was also not a realistic option. So even though it's not very actual anymore, because at the time I made the vlog it was quite actual, I still want to talk about it. A lot of people, and I think also a lot of my subscribers, will know either Gavin Free or McTurney. McTurney has her own channel with, I think, beauty vlogs and whatnot more. Also streams. She does do games and streams. And most people will know Gavin Free from the Slow Mo Guys, which is his own channel with about at least 10 plus subscribers, 10 million plus subscribers. He got like the gold or platinum play button for 10 million subscribers. And if you don't know him from the Slow Mo Guys, you might know him from Rooster Teeth, the company that owns Achievement Hunter, Let's Play, and Rooster Teeth, the channel itself, which did the series Red vs. Blue in the early 2000s, in the early YouTube days. And nowadays does a lot more. You might have seen Gavin Free in his very first movie appearance, which is Laser Team. This, by the way, is a movie made by Rooster Teeth. You may have heard the Million Dollar Butt game, which is an actual game, but also a YouTube series, which is the result of one of Gavin's his brain farts. So he has been out there. And if you have not heard of him, I'm sure you know his work. Because almost everyone has seen either Sherlock Holmes or Sherlock Holmes Game of Shadows. Those two films with Robert Downey Jr. The slow-mo scenes were filmed by Gavin Free. So you have seen something about him. And apparently McTurney had a fan, which was really, yeah, really liked her. And was interested in her and whatnot more. And, well, didn't agree with Gavin being there. It appeared that he even had some hatred towards him. And end of January, begin February, Gavin freeze together with Dan. As the Slow Mo Guys, they hit the 10 million subscribers. There's a video on McTurney's channel where they actually are staying up late just so that they can view it and see the number tick over. A week later, 10 days later, this fan drove from Albuquerque to Austin, which is 110 kilometers or 110 miles, I want even to say. 110 miles, yes. He broke in at a place. The couple was still awake at that time and they heard the glass shatter, so they hide in the closet and called the police. The burglar in question searched the house, couldn't find them, shot some random shots, walked outside, jumped in his car, and at this point police arrived. So they had this standoff situation with the burglar. And at that point one shot was heard, according to the news and the official police report, and the perpetrator, the burglar, shot himself. They actually found letters at his home and inside his car where it was very clear what his intentions were. He wanted to hurt or even kill Gavin and set Mac free by any means necessary, whatever that means. Now, there are two things that bother me about this. One is that there are people out there who actually want to hurt or kill people who have success because they have success and want to, and actually doing the act, actually going there with the sole purpose to kill somebody because in your mind they are not worth your idol and what not more reasons you have. That's already insane for me. Yeah, the second thing is that you haven't heard a single thing about it in the news. I even went to look at UK websites because Gavin Free is British. The Dan who made the slow-mo guys with him is British. So you would think at least somewhere inside all those British news agents, somebody would have picked the story up and did something with it, but nobody. Which in one way is also really peculiar. For me it's weird that something like that doesn't get picked up by the news. And it is the second YouTube burglary in a very short period of time. I want to say within 2 weeks or 3 weeks of time, and the other one was a fan of Paul Logan who just let himself in and was sitting on the couch when Paul got home. So he did a burglar arrest with, seems like me, a little bit exaggeration. I mean, you could just call the cops and, you know, let him sit if he's not doing anything harmful. It for me seems a little bit too much, was not needed. But then again, Paul is famous for doing a little bit too much from time to time. Okay, so there was no news or whatever here in this country, for as far as I'm aware of. Maybe somewhere in one of the newspapers, very short article, but not what I anticipated. So in the end I found out because Rooster Teeth does this podcast series, and I tend to watch not all of them. It really depends on who is inside the cast, and it's easy listenable. You don't have to watch it per se, you can just listen. So you can put it on while working on something else. When I do electricity work, so just cutting cables and soldering, a little bit like that, which isn't too difficult, I just put that on and listen to it. I sometimes do it when I'm cleaning the leopard geckos, although normally I put on Formula One. One of those podcasts in the end, he talked about it very shortly, just said, okay, thank you for the support of the Austin police and thank you for the support of all the fans. The company Rooster Teeth kept it quiet at request of Gavin so that not much got out. They could handle it privately, which I think is very kind of the company to do so, to give them that space that they wanted. But yeah, it puzzled my mind for a little bit that stuff like that happens. Even though this is the first attempt at a deadly attack on a YouTuber, for as far as I could tell, for as far as I could find. But yeah, something to think about. Something I wanted to talk about, because for me it is just, I just can't wrap my head around it. And that for me alone is enough reason to talk about it. And like and subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys later.
There is one more thing that we want to talk about. We know that some of you have probably read reports in newspapers or online about an armed intruder that broke into Gavin's house. And we didn't talk about this previously on the podcast because obviously it's a very difficult subject to talk about. Gavin, is there anything that you want to say about this?
Just massive thanks for all the support. online. It was a very unpleasant time. And also a big thanks to the Austin Police Department for an insanely fast response time.
Very fast. 4 minutes, right?
Yeah.
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 All right. Well, obviously, it's this is also a difficult topic to end the podcast on. But Gavin, we just want to say we love you and Meg very much. And we're happy that you're safe. We're very grateful that you're safe.
Thank you very much.
All right.